Hello, in this video I'm going to show you the new feature called the Houdini Engine Sync Session. This allows us to get our HTAs instantly viewed in Unity and Houdini. So first of all, make sure you are installing the Houdini Engine over here. And if you have the new version, you will see a tab called Sync Session. So this will create a new menu. You can either start Houdini or connect to a Houdini. So I already have Houdini open, so I want to connect to it. And in Houdini itself, I'm also going to enable a tab. So I will go here, create a new tab, go here at the bottom. And we also have here a option for the sync connection. Now I want to start this here in Houdini, and I also want to connect it here from Unity. If everything works right, in object layer now, you will have a global node. Now here in my project, I have a couple HTAs. So I have my stair tool. So here's my stair tool in Unity, and here also in Houdini. So the cool thing now, if I make a change here, like this, it will automatically translate into Houdini. Also with the parameters, these are still working. So if we increase the width, we would now have a live session between the two softwares. We can also change parameters the other way around. So I can go here into my stair tool in Houdini, and we have the same parameters that I had in Unity. So here we can still play around with these parameters, and you can see it instantly translates this into Unity. Another feature with the sync connection is we can actually create nodes in Houdini and have them instantly showed in Unity. So let's say we don't have an HTA in Unity. I'm going to here click on Create. Now, automatically, you will see popping up a new geometry node. You will also see here, actually, this was the original name that we gave it. So you can customize this as well. You can also change the types here if you want to have a curve or a certain input. So now let's dive into this geometry network. And we see here our output node. Right now, if I use a box and plug it in on the output, we will see a box here as well. So since I'm using the HDR pipeline, you can see that the material is pink. So I'm going to use a Unity material, and I can just here assign this as well. I can assign a material here automatically. And now this cube has this material. And of course, you can have input other geometry. Let's try out the test geometry. So the classic pig head. And now we have the pig head here as well. Also useful here is we can actually sync our viewports. So what would happen if I now would move my viewport is that they both have the same angle. This works both ways again. This is really cool to see. So we can plug in now here any geometry. I made sort of like a little stone generator. So I have my sphere, which is quite high poly. I do a mountain to get some interesting shapes. And then we assign the material. So this works really fast, so I can play around with the shapes a bit more. Once a certain setup is made, we can actually here press our save button. So we can save actually here this information. So in this case, let's call it small rock generator, for example. So I'm gonna delete this over here. And you will also see that automatically deleted in Houdini. And we're gonna load back our sync session. And we have it back. So it's then pretty cool to start experimenting in Houdini. We can save it and we can always later load it and change it. So that was it for this video. We showed you some new features about the Houdini sync session. This is a very cool feature and brings up your game creations to the next level.